Right, we open the stage now for Q&A. Can we ask, request the members of the press to just go a little back, please?
Hello. Hi, my name is Ravi, and I'm from Zing. Mera sawal Bhatt saab se hai. Bhatt saab, jaanna chahunga aapse, 1987 ki film aayi thi, Mr. India, aur is baar aa chuki hai, jaise hum dekh sakte hain, Mr. X. तो ये जो फिल्म है इनविजिबिलिटी के ऊपर ही बनी बन रही है, तो कितना खास है ये फिल्म, क्या मिस्टर इंडिया जैसा ये कमाल कर सकती है ये फिल्म?
जैसे विक्रम ने अपने छोटे से तकरीर में कहा, ये रोमांस जो है इनविजिबल मैन के साथ सदियों पुराना है। ये इनविजिबल मैन के कॉन्सेप्ट को हॉलीवुड ने इनविजिबल मैन के एक नाम की फिल्म में दिया था 1930s में। इनके ग्रैंडफादर विजय भट्ट साहब ने प्रकाश पिक्चर्स में इनविजिबल मैन 1937 में बनाई थी। मेरे फादर नाना भाई भट्ट ने अशोक कुमार साहब के साथ में 1957 में बनाई थी। उसके बाद में 60s में मिस्टर एक्स इन बॉम्बे नाम की एक फिल्म बनी थी, फिर बनी थी मिस्टर इंडिया, और अब 2015 में जब हिंदुस्तानी सिनेमा का मैार कहाँ से कहाँ पहुँच गया है, हमारे मुल्क में वो स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स आज पॉसिबल हैं जिसके बारे में कल तक हम सोच ही नहीं सकते थे। तो 3D का एक्सपीरियंस जो इस फिल्म के द्वारा आपको हासिल होगा, पूरे परिवार को हासिल होगा, इसका आप अंदाज़ा लगा ही नहीं सकते। तो मुझे लगता है कि एक बहुत ही अनोखी कहानी, एक अनोखे अंदाज में इस दौर की ज़रूरत को पूरा करते हुए, क्योंकि आज के दौर में एक फास्ट पेस कॉम्पैक्ट फिल्म की आवश्यकता है, मगर जो स्पेशल इफेक्ट्स हैं और 3D एक्सपीरियंस है और कहानी है वो बिल्कुल अलग है मिस्टर इंडिया से, क्योंकि हर फिल्म जो है उसके वक्त का एक एक्सप्रेशन होती है। 2000 की सदी जो है, जब सेंचुरी शुरू हुई थी, वो अलग है बिल्कुल 20th सेंचुरी से। तो ये कहानी जो है इस डेकेड की एक देन है।
मिस्टर महेश भट्ट, आई वुड ऑल्सो लाइक टू नो दैट अशोक पंडित अ कपल ऑफ डेज बैक ट्वीटेड सेइंग दैट the film was illegally withheld by Pehlaj Nihlani, and finally, you know, with the help of a CBFC committee member, the certification is being passed. So what was the story exactly behind that, and why did someone from within the committee actually have to go ahead and tweet about it?
Well, I do not claim to have the detailed insight about the so-called locking of horns between my brother Mukesh Bhatt, who was dealing hands-on with this problem, and the chairperson. But since I was away in Karachi with a play of mine called Daddy, but I was informed that in spite of the committee giving it a clear UA, in these times where everybody dreads what is going to happen to them, we were lucky to convince a committee which saw the film and gave it a clean UA, because I said this is a family entertainer with just one word to be dubbed. After that, we were assured that after we accepted that the certificate would be given to us the next day. But I'm told that some technicality was used as a ploy to delay the process of giving the certificate to us, as a result of which my brother said that there was a screening of this film kept at the PVR for the productions staff and also some people of the media, which had to be cancelled because you can't show a film within in a cinema hall without a official censor certificate. Then I was told that Mukesh, my brother, knocked at the doors of the ministry at the center, and with the support of some people within the censor board and the support of the members of the board, the process was accelerated. And finally, on a day when the censor board was closed at the behest of the people in Delhi, in the Ministry of Information Broadcasting, the office was opened and the certificate was given. So while we may have something to complain, we have a lot to be very happy about, that there were people within the censor board and the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting which made the process possible, accelerated the process, and we got the certificate.
Right. Also, Mr.
Bhatt, just shut up.
Okay. Also, Mr. Bhatt, the same committee member went ahead to call the Pehlaj Nilani an anarchist. Do you believe with the term that was used for Pehlaj Nilani?
Sorry?
Ashok Pandit also went ahead to call him anarchist. So do you feel that he was right somewhere down the line when Pehlaj Nilani was tagged as anarchist?
I don't understand. What were you saying?
Bhatt Sahab, he's saying that Ashok Pandit in the tweet said that Mr. Nilani was almost like an anarchist.
I do not know why he said what he said, whether he said what he said, and what, why did he use that word. It's not my experience, so I can't answer that question on his behalf.
Imran and Vikram, do you feel relieved that, you know, finally the certificate is being passed, and how are you feeling right now?
Well, I'm, I guess, more relieved than Vikram. I've not had too many films that I would boast and say they're UA certificate films. But this is just one of those films, the first film actually, that I would, without stressing out, would show it to my son and my family. Because also kids will love the experience. I really didn't know how it would all come together. I saw the film yesterday, and it's an absolute delight. It's like a roller coaster ride with the Invisible Man, with the action sequences in 3D, or even if you don't see it in 3D. So I'm really relieved that there is a certain audience that the film that we did 2 years back was a huge success, Raaz, but it was an A certificate film. It didn't have the audience that this has that could come in additionally and see this film and enjoy it because of the erotic quotient that, and of course the blood. So yeah, I'm looking forward to kind of tapping into that potentially new audience.
Bhatt Sahab, ek sawal aapki bhai aur ki tekniki tevar jo hai film ka wo nazar aa raha hai aur film kafi technically bahut advanced nazar aa rahi hai. आपको नहीं लगता कि तकनीक के इस दौर में इत्मीनान का सिनेमा कहीं ना कहीं होता जा रहा है?
लास्ट लाइन क्या थी?
तकनीक के इस दौर में इत्मीनान के सिनेमा के, जिसके लिए आपका एक सिग्नेचर स्टाइल था, आप जाने जाते थे, वो खो रहा है?
हाँ, ये इसमें कोई दो राय नहीं है कि हमारा सिनेमा अपनी जड़ों से कटता जा रहा है, मगर मिस्टर एक्स में जो कहानी विक्रम जी ने लिखी है, आप देखेंगे कि इसमें तकनीक का उपयोग तो किया गया है, मगर ये हमारे मुल्क के ईथॉस से कनेक्टेड है, हमारे मुल्क के अपना जड़ों से कनेक्टेड है. इसमें हमारी माइथोलॉजिकल रेफरेंसेस का भी जिक्र है, तो ये बिल्कुल अपने मिजाज में हिंदुस्तानी फिल्म है. इसमें आज के दौर के जो 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 डिस्कॉर्स है, जिसमें विवाद चल रहा है लॉ कानून व्यवस्था को लेकर और सारे इश्यूज को लेकर, उसका भी एक बहुत ही क्लियर आर्टिकुलेशन है. तो मैं कहूँगा कि एक बहुत ही स्वच्छ साफ किस्म की फैमिली एंटरटेनर के अलावा, ये इट डजेंट डम डाउन. ये कहीं पर लोग सिनेमा, ये कहानी जो है, इट डजेंट लुक डाउन, इट लुक्स अप एट द ऑडियंस, क्योंकि आज का दर्शक बहुत ही इवॉल्व है, तो उसको बिना नीचे देखे उसका सम्मान करते हुए विक्रम जी ने ये कहानी लिखी है, और उसके उसके कंटेम्प्रेरी टेस्ट को मद्देनजर रखते हुए ये फिल्म बनी है.
इमरान, माय क्वेश्चन इज टू यू. गुड आफ्टरनून, दिस इज विक्रम फ्रॉम एनडीटीवी. टू योर लेफ्ट, मिस्टर इंडिया वाज इन 1987. द किड्स ग्रोइंग अप देन, ही वाज अ सुपर हीरो फॉर देम, राइट? वी वर ऑल ग्रोइंग अप देन. अनिल कपूर बिकेम अ सुपर हीरो फॉर ऑल द किड्स देन. But these are days when the Avengers are flying in on the 24th of April. We have Superman, and you know, a lot of the television is closer. How do you think Mr. X will fight all those superheroes as well as a legend like Mr. India?
These films don't have the story of Krishna and Arjun. It's rooted in our culture, and I think that's unpurchasable. You might have all the special effects. Obviously, Hollywood, you can't match with them because they have a world audience. Our budgets are smaller compared to theirs. Their VFX, obviously, they've been doing it for decades together. But I think in our film, there is inherently, and I keep going back to this, this, of course, there will be a very new experience for the Hindi audience to see the VFX and the 3D in this. But it comes down to the story that I would boast about the most. It's the story of resurrection. It is a story of how people can endure despite of limitations and hurdles that they they can move forward and achieve what they want. And that's exactly what Mr. X is. It is the story of the Rising Phoenix. I wouldn't really box him up into a superhero, so I wouldn't want to really compare it to films like Avengers. It's highly debatable. Like I keep saying that Mr. X wouldn't have a problem putting a bullet into anyone. It's a personal vendetta story, and there are very valid emotions attached to that. So I think if you sum up everything with the story, with the emotional base, with the philosophy that the film has, it could also take on an Avengers.
Thank you so much.